What's your plan?
I don't want to do, man.
You've got to do yours.
No, I don't want to do it. I tried a bit too hard.
You're among friends, Johnny. Come on, do us your poem. Don't be shy.
Oh, no, it's going to be dead embarrassing.
No,
now.
Come on.
It's really long, man. it's not all of them. It's not all of them. It's a page.
OK.
I apologise.
Johnny Vegas, everyone.
In advance.
Don't apologise. No. Commit to the book. Right, commit to it, Johnny.
OK, all right, all right. It's about last orders. That's not for whom that bell doth toll as wordy barmaid's eyes do roll. A landlord with an earnest shout calls time on drinks and ushers out. The dutiful sup up and leave, but he's a last card up his sleeve. With feet like landlocked deep-sea diver, shuffles barwards with a fiver. He begs the lass for just one more, and one yourself, just make it right. He promises to drink it quick, yet deep down knows he's feeling sick. Not from stout or bags of scratchings, more from questions booze keeps asking. What happened to the happy me? I think, no hang on, need to pee. In the bog the poet sways, poised to ponder fonder days. Before the time of cheap warm cider, eyes of wonder opening wider. Now they narrow, tired of fun, as fart turns wet and burns the bum. Yet Rory's smile pops in his head till urine runs down inside leg. And thus the landlord shows him out, the child inside is crying out. I was not meant for such sweet sorrow, but opts instead for see you tomorrow. Thou stout, soaked, sig-stained, feckless soul, is what for, not whom, that bell did toll.
Oh. I mean, come on. I think we have a winner. Come on. Yeah. That was heartbreaking.
It was about a friend.
G'day, I'm Adam Hills. Join me along with Alex Brooker, Josh Widdicombe and Johnny Vegas.
I did it! Sorry. It was a bit of a twat and he's under some carpet. In Turner Park. He always shouted at dogs. Sorry, go on. I made sure to make eye contact. I was going to go around the back, but I thought, I want you to fucking know who did this.
Two more.
Oh, fucking hell. I once had a wank over a nun. I used to piss in the bath and pretend I was James Bond and it was acid. And I used to sit there and, like, work out how long I'd go without giving them, you know, telling them the answers to everything they wanted to know. Anyway, let's do this. Feels good to get it off your chest.
Okay. Here we go.
It's nice to share it with a live audience. Right, go on.
I'm snotting.
G'day, I'm Adam Hills. Join me along with Alex Brooker, Josh Whitty. I'm so sorry. I was holding it together. And you know, all he did was...
No, I'll do nothing. Sorry.
Okay. Oh, shit, this is going to take forever.
I expect you to smell of piss, Mr. Bond.
Oh, why am I crying in the promos?
I saw a bloke catch a carp and put his penis in its mouth and I told no one. He should have lost his fucking rod licence.
Ha ha ha!
police wrote a strongly worded letter to the Ambulance Association.
Okay. Yep.
Balls deep, he wasn't. You know what fish are like? They look shocked enough, don't they? It's not the natural environment.
Men are too embarrassed to undergo beauty treatments. True or false?
Well, you've undergone a few. Or is that a natural tan?
This is natural.
Oh, that's a natural tan, is it?
Well, I've had sunbeds, but I've quit sunbeds now. I don't have sunbeds no more, so...
You've quit sunbeds?
Quit.
My God, so you've made some sacrifices, haven't you? No. When did you quit sunbeds?
Like last week.
So, what's your daily regime, beauty-wise? What do you do, beauty-wise?
Obviously, you know, I wake up, look at myself, and I think, ream. But then I get... Then what? Then I get in and I get in the shower, do my hair afterwards. Bang, bang. What are you saying?
Bang, bang. And who's over there?
That was meant to be the mirror.
Oh, I thought that was your carer. Jennifer, you're a lady now. Do you think men are too pampered these days? Do we
yeah,
too much?
Yeah, yeah, I do. I like men, like, hairy, smelly.
Johnny Vegas. John, do you do any?
No, I wouldn't say I'm too embarrassed. I just think the prettier you are, the more you're going to disappoint someone at some point, cos they'll think, oh, that's the one, and then you go,
So you don't do any beauty treatment?
I had my first extraneous nostril hair this week.
It's terrible, isn't it?
Yeah, it was the first one. I was driving and I just checked my rearview mirror and it was there.
Hello!
That was the first vanity issue I've had of, like, well, that needs sorting, and there's no reason. I shouldn't have just let them all come out.
How'd you get it out?
No.
I just pulled and I pulled until I cried.
When you get to Boots and buy your first nasal trimmer, the way the girl looks at you, you know, and she slides it across with the beep.
I don't know, Johnny.
Well, and you can't look away, cos if you look away, you give them a better angle.
Sure. Beauty treatments.
I have had waxing, but I won't take my trousers off. They have to do it keyhole.
So what do you think?
I'm going to get you a diffuser.
A what?
And then you can't technically say, even that's another step away from blow drying.
A diffuser?
Yeah, it's one, you know, with the little spikes in there, you just run it through. What it does, it breaks it up and you'll get no split ends.
What have you done with a real Johnny Vegas?
Johnny, what do you use on your hair?
Hey, sunshine, I had a perm, all right, that, 2 minutes. I used to lacquer, I used a mousse, I used a diffuser. Didn't towel dry, cos that created heat and friction. No, I'm wrapped now, now give it 20 good minutes. I treated it with respect. I hope that shit falls out.
I didn't mean half into that, man.
Yeah, well, you did, and you know what? Give out for that. Look after it, you don't know where you go while you're young.
OK. So most men are too embarrassed to undergo beauty treatments...
I'm going bald! Look at that.
That's not that bad.
No.
I'm worse than that. Mind you, I think that's because I have very vivid dreams.
Pillow.
OK, so most men are too embarrassed to undergo beauty treatments. True or false? What are you going to say, Sean?
True.
You think it's true? You think they are too embarrassed?
Yes,
Sean,
I do,
what do you
yes.
think?
Team?
Jennifer, what do you think? False. Are most men false. Too embarrassed?
False.
You can go false. OK. I can tell you the answer is false. Oh. You got it. Yes. Yes, only 43% of men said they'd be too embarrassed to have...
I've been told I smell better from behind than I do from the front. So, that bit in between...
You sweat more?
I'm wondering
what
if
do you
I
do,
can
sorry?
Trap the journey.
He smells better from behind than he does from the front.
No, lovers have told me.
Lovers have told me.
Great night. If I come in the room backwards, it helps to maintain the mood.
Now, let's move on. What happens in the rhubarb triangle?
The marzipan fighter planes go missing.
It's a nice
they, do they not pick anything up on the licorice radar and then they, suddenly start talking nonsense and gingerbread men, good men,
brave.
Fought in the pudding wars. just vanished and the wives are stood there holding their eyes going, this is all they found.
I want to live in your world, Johnny.
Now, what's this? What's this? What's this? Pass it down. Just all you've got to do is tell me what it is. Have a taste. It's, I promise you, not poison, despite being green.
It's not wasabi, is it?
Wasabi, no.
Well,
wasabi.
You would be served this if you were to go out around London and go to most Japanese restaurants, and I would have a taste. I mean, whoa!
As close to wasabi as you can get without it being wasabi. I nearly took a bit, a mouthful of that, you know.
Oh, it's not a joke. I can't take chili, but I can take the mustard.
I put a load in because you said it wasn't.
You said it's not wasabi.
It's not wasabi. I'll tell you what it is. I'll tell you what it is.
It's not jackass, it's QI.
What you're eating there is horseradish. Now, you may say wasabi is Japanese horseradish, but the wasabi you get sold in British restaurants is almost always ordinary British horseradish dyed green.
No.
Yes. Because real wasabi, although it's related to horseradish, takes 2 years to mature and it's very expensive to transport. So it's much easier to use the British stuff, which grows on railway sidings and is cheap as chips, to use that instead.
You know what, Stephen? That would have been lovely just if you'd explained it and used some bloody pictures. Rather than give us some and go, put that in your mouth.
I'm so sorry.
I can hear things like a dog does. Dumb things in me. This it's... might have been way normal. I had to become a superhero and all you had to do was give me a bloody spoonful of that. See through walls!
What are these men looking at?
Their feet.
No, there's something, higher up.
I think they're looking...
It's higher
than labels.
That.
They're navel gazing.
Yes. They're engaged in omphaloskepsis, or navel gazing. So the Greek for navel is omphalos. And apparently it's an aid to meditation. That doesn't look like what they're doing, does it? But in some yoga practices, it's regarded as an aid to meditation.
It looks like, it looks like they're thinking, these pills I bought on the internet are not working.
They're very varied, aren't they? I mean,
yeah.
Belly buttons.
An innie and an outie and a kind of natural horizon.
Honestly, if you combine it with my man dress, whenever I take my top off, it looks like my midriff has been rejected for a loan. It looks so depressed, like it's filled out all the forms and everything.
But if you stand on your hands, does it look like it's got the
I could turn upside down and it looks like it's in tax exile.
Johnny.
Tell you straight off.
Come on.
Sister had a goldfish.
Lovely.
She left for college. Mm-hmm. She begged me to look after it. Within 3 weeks of going, I sold it to a local aquarium for 80p to buy some cider.
How bad is an aquarium that one of their features is an 80p goldfish?
Ah, I'm glad you asked. It wasn't just a goldfish, it was a comet tail, which she didn't know when she'd won me at the fairground.
Oh.
Otherwise, I'd have only got 40p and it wouldn't have been worth me time.
80p cider, though. Good on you, Johnny.
I'm looking at that fish now and it's a bit guilt. My sister had gone to college, she was lonely. She had one thing to come back for. Three brothers who she didn't get on with, but one fish. And I enjoyed telling her it was gone.
Don't go down that route, Johnny.
If you're going to do these Jerry Springer-style shows, emotions are going to be wrong. I've got this little friend. Because since my other one left me... me and him have some fantastic chats. He'll only let me drink coffee. And he doesn't let me make the life mistakes that I used to. Going on TV, selling yourself short. You used to be a cutting-edge comedian! Sort your life out! It's tricky for the audience because I'm the only one who can see him.
Is he drinking meths?
Pachine.
Your missus told me off the other day for giving you Pachine.
You did. You got a sore drunk. Yeah. I'm not allowed to talk about.
Yeah, sure. It was funny.
How many parties are happening?
Get yourself an angry boot, you found out, won't you? And try making a fucking mess now and again. You did a bad thing.
Spank that monkey.
He's not a monkey, he's a baboon. For very obvious legal reasons. He's an angry baboon.
Put it in to say that with these on, Johnny, it looked like it was 50 Shades of Johnny. as Donald Trump, I mean, have you? Would you consider one of those raunchy kind of, you know, sex movies?
Of course I would. Yeah. For people who are into a man crying. Relentlessly crying and saying, I'm sorry. I'd call it 50 Shades of Spent. Because I'd probably do something to myself before I, you know, did the scene.
Right, OK.
back Adam? To the news.
Yeah.
Why did you ask the question?
Yeah, I was wondering. back to the news now, Donald Trump...
I came on here for politics! But now you must, yes, there's a lot of times when I get nervous, I rid myself of evil desires. Once in a bus prior to voting. He said, where do you want to put your ex? And I went, not again.
Right.
And the worst thing is, some of it went in a bird's nest. Then I imagined that a bird would grow up looking like me. And would someday swim down and take me away and go, you're my father. By accident.
Oh, I am loving imagining what our producers are doing at the
Okay, hey, this is exciting. This is the time of year when a lot of people are being booked out. Johnny's got a book out. It's very, very different to the kind of book that normally a comedian or a TV person would write. Tell us about the idea behind this, because it is quite unique, I think.
It's becoming Johnny Vegas, but it's going back to me as Michael Pennington and plotting where Johnny came from.
So Johnny is, for you, Johnny Vegas, the comic persona we know, it does feel like a different person.
Well, it always felt like a different person. It always felt like there was a line in the sand. It was me, I'd put the flares on, I had the Celine Dion. But look at that.
See, when I first saw photographs, I didn't know that was a perm. I thought that was what your hair was but
it's technically not a perm, it's a demi-wave. Only people in the business would know.
So why did you have that done?
I had it done because this guy who lived in my head went, we should have a perm. We really should go out and get something. If women aren't going to look at us, we should have a reason for women not to look at us. And the best reason for women not to look at you is to have a perm. If you're not a footballer from the 1970s.
But here's the thing. I think if a lot of people had the voice in their head or something like that, they would try and fight against it. They wouldn't embrace it. And yet you chose to follow that path and embrace him. Were you not tempted to try and sort of push it away?
I did, but I had very little to sort of associate with. I went away from a young age. I trained for the priesthood. That was a massive shift in my life. And then when I left there and people are going, he's that police boy, he's the weirdo. This voice was the only person who seemed to understand me, and it didn't feel strange to have this voice in my head. And it wasn't something... It wasn't telling me to go out and start fires.
No.
You know what I mean? There was nothing bad enough happening. He was just a bloke walking around, sort of going, you know what I'll say to him if I ever get the chance? And then one day, eventually, you pick up a microphone and somebody goes, oh, you fat get, and he goes, let me tell you. I know about you, what I've been watching and waiting.
So it freed you to unleash the comic kind of force within, or the kind of the observational force within?
Well, it wasn't even a comic force within. It was just that bloke going, I'm sick of you taking crap. He was like a little Mr. Miyagi.
Yeah.
But he never taught me how to fight.
Perm on, perm off.
Yeah.
The booze.
Scrunch! Diffuser!
Johnny, you described, you were with us in Rio for the Paralympics last year. Yeah. You described the Paralympics as a game changer. Roisin's never seen the Paralympic Games before. Can you explain to her what's so great about parasports?
It was being part of something that you're going, I think you would watch on telly and go, oh, well done. And then when you get out there, you go, God almighty, this is like the most collaborative, inspiring.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? The stories behind, but isn't that the most competitively, fiercely, the way they speak about each other off the field. Everything about it was where you're going, I've never, outside of rugby league, been so immersed in sport.
Yeah.
Because athletics always put me off.
Why?
Because it was wankers at school. His dad was a lawyer. And these were people who came out and competed.
Do you know what? I do think
they really competed, but took the time as well to talk to you. After, do you know what I mean? You were in there.
Yeah. I mean, some disabled people are wankers, but...
Try working with them, mate. Try working with them.
Are you up?
I had a massive finger that was going to be lowered.
Roisin, right. Will you go to some events over the next week?
I'd like to, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I watched that race earlier. It was incredible, so I got really invested.
It's one of those things that you don't really realise how much you're going to get into it until you actually go there and watch it live.
Yeah, I got pretty into it pretty fast.
I did. Yeah,
which is good, as it was 17 seconds.
Exactly. I'm all or nothing.
You don't know either until you come back. You actually don't know the impact until you come home. And you speak to people, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I find it's most difficult to talk about it without talking about it in some condescending tone, and it isn't. You're out there, you're getting hammered with the basketball team, you end up accidentally being a linesman, you go to watch a guy doing bowling, who's, you know what I mean, paralysed from the neck down, and I'm sat there going, arsehole. Why have you bowled that? Why have you bowled that? And you can sit with him afterwards and go, mate, you need me as a coach.
It's here that you used to make people laugh at school by playing a Hawaiian tune on your nose.
Yeah.
Is that a real thing? Can we hear that?
Do you want...
Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Vegas on the nose.